Morning, brother. How are you? Morning, Aunt G. How you doing? Well, I guess we'll go ahead and get started. Good morning to all, and welcome once again to Tuesday Bible Talk Devotional. I pray everything's all right with everybody. There's so much happening. There's anticipation of some positive things that are happening. There seem to be things on the horizon that'll work out for the benefit of the citizenship of the U.S., and let's not get anxious. Let's not get anxious for anything. We survived 4 years of torment and whatever. So let's just be patient and watch things play out with the vaccine and see if we can get the economy re-stimulated and get people back to work and get our kids back to school. But in all that, let's just remember that God is fully in control. So we need to pull back and let God be God. We do the parts we can do that he asked us to do, but let's not get out in front of him, because his grace and his mercy, the things of God, are on the horizon. So let's just let God be God again. Let us pray. Dear gracious Father, we thank you for another blessed day. We thank you for our opportunity to share your word, share your will, share your way. We thank you, Father, that you've brought us such a mighty long way. If we each looked into our lives, we could see your glory. We could see your smiling face. We could see your hand just stirring the pot and making our lives better each and every day. For this, Father, we thank you. Sometimes we overlook Thanksgiving. We thank you, gracious Father, and we praise your holy name. It is in Jesus' name that I pray and I give thanks. Amen. Well, for a time like this, I found a scripture that I feel very, very apt, very appropriate for this time, and I just want to share it with us. Good morning, Pastor Taylor. How are you, sir? And it's Hebrews 12, 1 and 2. Therefore, since we are surrounded by so great a cloud of witnesses, let us lay aside every weight and sin which clings so closely, and let us run a race with endurance. Let us run with endurance the race that is set before us, looking to Jesus, the founder and perfecter of our faith, who for the joy was set before him endured the cross, despising the shame, and is seated at the right hand of the throne of God. Morning, Mom. How are you? As this scripture says, Jesus is the founder and perfecter of our faith. The scripture in itself is exhorting us to release every cause, every temptation, every internal, every external reasoning for walking outside the will, way, and word of God. Because we are surrounded by such a cloud of witnesses, so many things witnessed to the faithful and the love of God. You know, these witnesses, biblically speaking, go from Abel in the beginning of the Bible in Genesis to Paul and him writing the Bible and his journeys to someone maybe sitting right next to you in your home, a child, a parent, a friend, a pastor. But there's such a great number of witnesses. It ought to be a little bit easier to keep our focus on the things that God does, and our resolve should be strengthened to endure whatever challenges the world presents to us in our daily walk as we venture to travel the path of righteousness, focused on our God the Father through Christ. Even those who aren't churched, people who aren't really into corporate worship, they don't read the Bible, but there are things that testify to the faithfulness and the love of God. Has a son ever taken a day off? That's a testament to God. You know, nobody gets up in the morning and says, I wonder if the sun's gonna rise. No, because God, that's in God's hands. We have no control over that. You know, in spite of mankind's worst efforts, I guess is the way I'll put it, we have air to breathe daily, free. We have water to drink daily. Should be free. It's not, but free. But we have access to those things. But that's because of God and his divine wisdom in creation. Our bodies naturally sync with the ecosystem. You know, as a matter of fact, it was made for us. Before God took and formed us from the dirt of the earth, he made provision. He put everything in place for us to live and live successfully. That's testament to God's goodness, to God being in place. You know, the earth, it spins just at the right speed for gravity to be conducive to our lives. It doesn't throw us off. It doesn't have us holding on like one of the rides at Six Flags. That's a testament to God. That is a witness to God. He said, if people won't witness, nature will be my witness. My creation itself will be a witness. You know, the sun is 93 million miles away from the earth. Yet, if we were 2 inches closer, we'd burn up. 2 inches farther away, we'd freeze. That's a testament to God, because only God is that precise. 93 million miles and 2 inches. I don't know if you've ever had a contractor in your house, but sometimes they don't get 2 inches right on 10 feet and come up short. So this is a testament to what God does and who he is. But all that said, there ought to be somebody. There ought to be something that testifies to the goodness of your God. Something has happened. Something you saw from your grandmother, your mother, from your kids ought to be a test. That ought to be a witness to your life about the power of God. If you come to church, if you're part of the organized worship, a corporate worship thing, there ought to be some people that you see, that you watch, and you see God just changing them, transforming them, making their lives different. I know, just looking at myself, God has just done some wonderful, wonderful things. I'm not talking about all the bad stuff that could have happened that God just swooped in and rescued me from. I'm just saying from the development of a person and making me a man and growing me into a man of God, I see his holy hand witnessing to his power. There's when I look at Pastor Taylor, Lord have mercy, 55 years with us. I know us. I know some of us in a way Pastor Taylor doesn't know us. And he didn't turn and walk away. He didn't turn and flee. He's there every day. That testifies to the goodness, the love, the mercy of God, because that's a godly man. When I look at my mother, I think about some 30 years ago, her stretched out and people telling me, you know, she probably ain't gonna make it. But if she is, if she does make it, it'll be 15 years or so before she can do anything for herself. And in 5-6 months, she was back at work. That's God testifying that I am bigger than the world. I am bigger than anything. There are these sisters at our church lost their father when they were young, lost their mother when they were growing, just getting into being women and developing their families. And I look at their lives, their walk with God. I look at how they've just grown into these wonderful women. And I know that God is saying to me, can you see what I am doing? We all need to stop and just look. Taste it and see it. And look at what God is testifying about himself through others to us. Then we might stop complaining and receive the joy that God has for each of us. There's a testimony. It doesn't have to be, oh, you know, I should have been dead and gone. It should. Sometimes it just needs to be, wow. Look at what God has done in my life as I just went along. No, I'm not a perfect person. No, I don't do everything right. No, I don't say everything right. Nope, I don't have perfect attendance at church. Nope, I'm not liked by everyone. But what I am is I'm loved by God. So through nature, through people, through love, God testifies to his faithfulness to me each and every day. That's what we need. We need some of the physical things, but our spirits need to be renewed. You know, the old church folks used to say, we need a revival. But we can't get a revival till we can truly see and understand that God is at work right now. He's testifying. He ain't testifying like some people do. He's testifying that I got you. I got you. I feel your heartache. I feel your pain. I see it. But I have empathy. Not sympathy. I have empathy. I'm feeling it with you. But I'm growing you. I'm walking you through something. And if you would just look around, you would see that I'm so much bigger than all of this. My word testifies to me. My love testifies to me. Your neighbor testifies to me. Your parents testify of me. You ought to testify of me. So I'm saying all this to say, out of that great cloud of witnesses, we don't have to sit down and read the Bible to find those witnesses. Look around. Look at yourself. Look at your life. Your life ought to be a living testimony to the love of God. Your parents' life can be a living testimony to the love of God. Your children's lives are a living testimony to the love of God. The fact that you're up this morning in your right mind, clothed, hearing this, walking and talking is a testimony to the love of God. Let's not let what's happening in the world get us away from what's happening in our spirits. What's happening with God? There is so great a cloud of witnesses to God's glory. And then the ultimate testimony to God's love and his faithfulness to us is just what's in this scripture, that Jesus, the founder and the perfecter of our faith, despising the shame, took on death, took on sin, our deaths, our sins, and defeated it, and is now seated at the right hand of the throne of God as an intercessor for us, making sure that everything's all right. So once again, this is just a faith check. If we, when we get down in the dumps, when we let doubt sneak in and Satan starts playing with our minds and our spirits, look around. The testimony is there. The goodness of God is shining bright. Look for the light, not the darkness, and it'll always be right there for you. There's a person, there's an event, there's something happening that testifies, that witnesses, that it's part of that great cloud of witnesses for God, right there available to you to strengthen your mind, your soul, and your spirit. That's my little message for today, because see, we just need to stay up. We need to stay faithful. We need to stay encouraged, and we need to stay close to one another. So despite all that's happening, look for your witnesses. Look for the goodness of God. It's right there for you. Amen. God bless you all. I pray that you have a lovely, lovely day, and God just does everything that he says he would do in your life. God bless you. Take care.